Our daughter was born prematurely at 27 weeks. We arrived in a place with no manual, no guidebook, and no comprehension. I'm an educator. I talk for a living. But when our daughter was born, I was so petrified, so terrified, so afraid, I could not speak. I just wrote. We arrived at the neonatal intensive care unit at dawn. Nurse Iris made us tea and toast. I didn't think I needed tea or toast. I was wrong. One of the nurses said, "And when she's stronger, we'll move her to Skaboo." And I thought, what a cute name for the nursery. Skaboo, Winnie the Pooh, Jemima Puddle Duck, Skaboo. And I smiled and nodded and tried not to look at the bleeping monitors. Weeks later, at another hospital, a nurse said, "Now you're here in Skaboo." And then it finally dawned on me. Skaboo is not a cartoon character. S-C-B-U. Special Care Baby Unit. I simply didn't get that. Despite my degree and my job and my ability to articulate, because hospitals make me anxious and the language of hospitals has no glossary. Families often live together in hospital accommodation. We are part of each other's lives. The common link is we all have a child who is living or dying on a unit a short walk away. Our daughter didn't recover well. The consultant said we would probably lose her. Moving to yet another hospital offered her a tiny chance of survival. I watched staff with their heads tilted to one side, hand on the shoulder of the parents. I dreaded the day a hand may be on my shoulder. I can't really tell you what happened because I just don't understand it. But the genius people that decided to study medicine saved our baby. I think about it, I cry about it, I'm still in shock. And I'm so delighted she is with us. Whilst our daughter's full recovery was unusual, our experiences are not exceptional. If you're connected to a family in intensive care, listen carefully for the words they're struggling to say. Make sure you avoid using medical jargon. Understand the intensity of intensive care.